Well, there. I turned off the noisy old pump. Yes. I wanted to talk to you today about one of the deep, dark secrets living in Southern California. Night and morning low clouds. I don't know how well you can see it, but the sky up there is not blue. It's cloudy gray all the way around. The little piece of sky that I can see here from my house is cloudy gray. Yep, and it's, well, let's see now. What time is it? Oh, now it's not going to tell me. Just what I wanted my phone to help me. No. What time is it?
It's 11 a.m.
Well, thank you, Google. Yeah.
I'm here to help.
Anyhow, here it is, an hour before noon, and the sky is completely over. No, it's not completely. It's trying to break through. Good heavens. Look at that. It's trying to break through. Oh, yes. It's trying. So maybe we'll see some sun, maybe not. But you see, here in Southern California, and especially here in San Diego, where I've spent, 40, 50 some years of my life, I've got 7 decades down now, and I'm starting to work on building up the 8th decade, and I'm 72 years old, 2/10 of the way towards 80 from 70. And I've spent 40 or 50 of those years here in San Diego. And there has always been May gray and June gloom. Later on in the summer, we get the vicious heat, August, September, even into October now, as the years are changing and the climate is changing and the year is shifting so that summer is longer. But clouds still rise from the sea and hanging low that is within 2,000 or 3,000 feet above sea level. They move against the land, fill up the sky over all the suburban valleys, and cover us all in what we call the marine layer. I remember my old Aunt Virginia, may she rest in peace. We were talking about it once in grandmother's house, her mother and my mother's mothers, where they grew up, and where my grandmother, their mother, still lived at the time, back in the 70s, when we were chatting about this local phenomenon. And my Aunt Virginia said, there is a trough aloft, which is one way of putting it, because the clouds flow in this trough above the land. They flow in and cover all the hills and valleys of the coast until they run up against the mountain. And there are times when the top of the clouds are way up in the mountains, and then the times when the top of the clouds are way down here. When I was a child once, I went to up on top of a local hill here, 1,200 feet above sea level, and it was just above the fog layer. And the whole city was covered with fog, a cloud at our feet. My friend and I stood up on top of the hill looking out over that. Oh my goodness, it was something. So, this is how we get a milder summer here than you get in the Inland Empire, up in San Bernardino and Riverside and Temecula, and in around LA in the inland valleys. Sometimes it'll get hot, while at the beach it's still cloudy and scarcely in the 70s or 80s. So that one of our local newscasters when I was a boy, a guy named Bob Dale, used to refer to this night and morning low cloud pattern as our natural air conditioning. And it's true, it is. It's part of the influence of the ocean, the marine influence, the marine layer. The clouds come in off the sea and they block the sun, so that when it's 120 in the desert and 90 degrees in the mountains, it may only be 70 at the beaches and 80 here in the inland valleys, where the clouds start to melt as the day goes on. Even now I can see the sun is trying to burn his way through the night and morning low clouds. It does have a problem, though, in that it blocks good astronomy. I couldn't see so many things because of the clouds coming in and blocking the moon and the planets. Oh, that's the way it is, I guess. And I'll just have to make do. But that's one of our secrets of Southern California. The night and morning low clouds. You either love them or leave them.